speak to us for a few moments. George is the former president of the board of directors, father, I guess, of three Brookwoods campers, and a host of grandkids who come to the camp, and he has a few thoughts for us to begin the evening.
To see Joe a week later. Joe changed vans. He was different. I sometimes don't get through this story, but I'm going to try. It's the closest thing to a miracle and a direct answer of prayer that anything I've ever seen. His attitude was, he was a different person. And he said to us, I think maybe there is a possibility. And he said, I had a strange thing happen this week, that I had a dream. He said, I dreamed I was walking over the Brookwoods trails and grounds, and suddenly I noticed there was somebody walking with me. And this person said, Joe Hyde, this cannot be a real estate development. It's got to stay as a camp. Said, the person walking side of me was the Lord Jesus Christ. And he said, and he just kind of blew up and he said, I don't want to be struck down by lightning. Goodbye the camp.
Court of the state of New Hampshire, and we won in the Supreme Court. So we maintained.
addition to his strong spiritual commitment and leadership, and we replaced all the utilities in the camp, the water system, the electrical system. We rebuilt many of the cabins and built some new cabins. There were structural problems in Deer Run. The floor went up and down, and maybe some of you remember, walked on it. Two people my size walked on it before from the ripple. And we thought, what'll happen if 100 people go down in the basement? So we fixed that up. And other improvements that you've seen, I think, Dave, you spoke of the extension of the kitchen, and we acquired Mrs. Mooney's property, first the hen house and then the house itself. And more recently, Dr. A's property. And then the parents' property, whatever it is, the guy who lived across the street there, and my mom's property. We now have pretty much refurbished and rebuilt the camp and expanded the facility. That's a little bit of a historical sketch. I have some notes here, but I'm not going to refer to them because I'm going to talk to Lauren. I have already. But let me just say that being connected with Camp Brookwoods in this way has been one of the high points, certainly, of my lifetime. And to see boys and girls' lives change through coming to Brookwoods and see the way the counselors and the CIT have worked with the young people has really been the most rewarding thing I know of. I just want to close with one story that would impress me in a way I'll never forget. And Miles, this was, where is Miles?
Over here.
Oh, this was at the campfire between the outgoing July campers and the incoming August campers. I think it was the bonfire where you had the awards. I attended, I was up here for that, and sat in the background, and this was mainly all Brookwoods, I think. These young boys, anywhere from age 9 up to maybe 13 or 14, were testifying as to what camp had meant to them. But the thing that really moved me was, as the award program progressed, it turned into a prayer meeting. These little youngsters